Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We extend a warm welcome to all of you to yet another PYP Indus Day. I am Aishwi from grade 2, and I, along with Mohit and Ame from grade 3 and Nirvi from grade 5, will be your hosts for the evening. Please join us in welcoming our chief guest, Mr. Krishna Sagar Rao, Principal of Indus International School, Hyderabad, Ms. Farida Frost, and our Vice Principal, Ms. Shweta Kothapalli, members of the leadership team, parents, teachers, and my friends.
Traditionally, the lighting of the lamp is a symbol of prosperity and represents success and marks an auspicious beginning. Just like we need light to drive out the darkness, we need the light of education to drive out the darkness of inequality, injustice, and violence and guide us towards progress, equality, and peace. We will begin our program with the lighting of the lamp. May I request Mr. Krishna Sagar Rao, Ms. Farida Fraz, Ms. Shweta Kothapalli, Ms. Shweta Jolly, and Ms. Sushmita Mohanty to light the lamp. To address the gathering.
Mr. Krishna Sagar, our PAC members, parents, and teachers. It's my pleasure, privilege, and honor to welcome you to this evening of celebration through a series of performances. Indus believes in the philosophy of whole education, which is about unlocking human potential, potential of our students, our eagles. The PAC has strongly cemented our bond with the parents. I thank you for believing in us. This evening is a tribute to all parents whose superstars have put in their heart, soul, and mind to take your breath away with their exemplar performances. Our theme for this year's Indus Day is adaptability, which resonates with the ethos and with our school motto, In Omnia Paratus, prepared for all challenges. The theme adaptability has been deliberately chosen. It took a pandemic for us to realize that we're all born with the seeds of growth mindset and adaptability. All it requires is nurturing. Whatever age we are, we can adapt to any given situation if we have an open mind. Our CEO, Lieutenant General Arjun Ray, often reiterates the point that as educators, we must not only teach the subject, but also the child. He never fails to point out that the purpose of education is to make our students future ready. Towards this, if I'm asked to advise our young students to pick one skill that will help them to be future ready and to be successful in their career and in their life, adaptability it would be. And the reason is that the world today is not the world we're going to be living in 5 years, 10 years, or 15 years from now. As General always says, we live in a VUCA world. It's volatile, uncertain, complex, and ambiguous. Yesterday's learning is obsolete today. New opportunities are knocking at the doorstep, and we must be open to innovative ideas. Now, while adaptability is a powerful skill, it is also a word that is thrown around a lot, a skill that is oversighted, without true understanding of what it really means. Adaptability is more than being flexible. It is about comfortable. It is about being comfortable in the uncomfortable. Speaking of taking steps towards progress and the better, at Indus, we not only focus on academics, but also on service through CAS in different areas on and off campus. In our efforts towards making the world a better place, this year, the school has undertaken the following service projects: reviving the Areca Leaf project for manufacturing plates and cutlery, women empowerment being the crux of this project. Midday meal program. We will be serving a nutritious meal to the Anganwadi schools in the surrounding villages starting Jan 2023. Organic farm on school campus. An acre of land has been identified for organic farming on the campus. Vegetables will be grown organically and will be used for the midday meal program. A lake revival project. Our students have identified a lake in the Kondakal village for adoption. Students will maintain this lake by conducting regular cleanup drives. Another area where we are becoming a better version of ourselves is sports. Sports is not just a physical activity, but an integrated approach for learning and a gateway to relieve stress. Our students have been soaring high at this front as well. Topil Bense Biju of grade 11 has participated in the rifle shooting national championship in Delhi and in the under 16 category rifle shooting nationals held in Kerala. Kunduru Ishanvi Reddy of grade 9 participated and won the first position in the 13th South Zone Shotgun Championship. Amaya Agarwal of grade 2 secured first place in the under 7 Ekagra All India below 2005 rated International Grandmaster Chess Tournament. Anay Agarwal of grade 2 secured 8th position in the under 7 Ekagra All India below 1600 fight rated International Chess Tournament. Agam Jain of grade 8 secured the first position in the under 14 boys category 100 meters race in the Hyderabad district meet. He also participated in the Telangana state meet. I would also like to take this opportunity to talk about the collaborative learning model at Indus. As part of the innovative culture encouraged by General Ray, Indus has introduced one-of-a-kind humanoid robot called Eagle 5. The robot has been introduced as part of the indigenously designed collaborative learning model, which facilitates man-machine learning. The collaborative learning model allows the human teacher more time to focus on the child, provide individual support, and personalized learning. Last but not the least, and this news is so fresh, it just came yesterday, we're delighted to announce that Sheen Gupta of grade 12 has been accepted to the Wharton School of the University of Pennsylvania to study economics. This marks our first Ivy League admission of this year. An extremely hardworking and dedicated student, Sheen is the MYP World Topper, our head girl, editor-in-chief of the Eagles Bulletin, and the president of the Interact Club. Please give her a huge round of applause. While I take pride in all of our achievements, it is also a moment to express my gratitude to all of you for supporting us at every step. We celebrate our Education World ranking to number 4 in India and number 1 in Telangana for the last 4 consecutive years. IISH is an incredible combination of vision, culture, and talent. And what makes us outliers are the people we are associated with, our parents, students, teachers. With this, let us begin this evening of astounding amazement as our young eagles are all set to win your hearts, not just with their cuteness, but with their dedication and hard work. Let us give them a huge round of applause. Thank you.
May you continue to motivate and inspire us as our school achieves great success under your able leadership and this community progresses to newer and greater heights every succeeding year.
Bharatanatyam is a form of Indian classical dance that originated from Tamil Nadu, known to express religious themes and spiritual ideas. Today, the students will be performing a dance themed around Lord Ganesha, the divine aspect associated with auspiciousness. Traditionally, Lord Ganesha is known to remove obstacles and enable our endeavors to succeed. With this thought in mind, I invite our young eagles to perform the beautiful invocation dance.
Yeah. ஆதி பிரியம் பூஷிகா கனமோதக பிரியம் மகாகணபதி வசிஷ்ட பாமதேவாதி.
Belongs to us if we create the capacity to receive it. An apt quote for the occasion. It is customary at Indus that we begin with Sri Rabindranath Tagore's lyrical prayer, where the mind is without fear. This composition resonates with the core values that teach us as individuals to always aim for freedom. Freedom of mind, speech, thought and belief, practice and behavior. Because ultimately, these are the things that go a very long way in molding us as people. Please welcome the students of grade 5 as they render the poem Where the Mind is Without Fear.
Shaktile jaye mere man
found in Solfal. Mr. Krishna Sagar Rao is a Harvard Business School certified organizational strategist. He is an internationally reputed organizational strategist and an author. In a career spanning 25 years, Mr. Krishna has successfully built and exited two large businesses in sales and consulting. He has coached thousands of senior organizational executives, military leaders, scientists, and CEOs in the areas of emotional intelligence, organizational leadership, business strategy design, and implementation. He is a highly qualified professional with two master's degrees in management, two postgraduate diplomas in advertising and organizational psychology. He has been engaged in application research in the area of emotional intelligence for over 25 years.
Mr. Krishna is also a prolific author. He has authored a bestseller, Summit Your Everest, a book on obstacle and failure management. His third book, Reflections of a Thought Leader, was launched recently. Sir, it is a pleasure and honor to have you here with us this evening as our chief guest. May I please request you to address the gathering?
Who's the, not MYP, I suppose, PYP head. And Rishu Talwar, who is the PYP head. And the, I see some familiar faces of my friends also, some here in the front rows. And of course, the two young children who introduced me, I am zapped that they actually by-hearted the whole profile. I mean, I was seeing if there is a teleprompter, but there was none. It's amazing. And that's what the kids are all about nowadays, the smartest. And I wish to recognize the amazing performances they have put. I think very limited, but still, they have done their two shows right here and organized themselves so very well. Let's give up a big round of applause to your kids performing here this evening. I see so many parents here. I am one too. I have a teenager, and you know, you're in the queue actually. You'll get there. So today's theme of adaptability actually stuck me. I mean, I didn't create this. I mean, Farida Faraz and his team has put together the theme called adaptability. And I specialize in emotional intelligence. And when they said you have to speak a little on adaptability, I said it could be a one-day workshop for parents. It's such an important and a very essential core competence. Not just for, okay, I got the names of Aishwi and Amay, the geniuses who by-hearted things so very well. Thank you. Even my prime minister has to see the teleprompter. Now, having said that, it's outstanding to see our kids. As I said, I have passed through the journey you are going through right now, and I have a 17-year-old. And at the stage where they look so cute, they're so sweet, and you feel like hugging them, kissing them, cuddling them up. But when they cross that age, which is so categorized as a dreadful time, and then you have all the issues. And why? And why did we categorize our kids as very sweet, cute, little cuddly kids too? The teenagers who are so challenging to handle. Now, while this is not a session, a workshop for the parents, I'm not here for that. I thought I'll share a few ideas which run through my mind, which are drawn from my specialization called emotional intelligence. Adaptability is such a powerful word. And I see most of you are either business or an enterprise or as a professional, a homemaker, whatever roles you are in, at the end of the day, what you carry home is what you want to carry home. Happiness, peace, stability. And of course, affection, love of your dear ones. But if you cannot adapt, those emotions are hard to find. And adaptability is such a natural competence of human species, the only species which could walk from cave to right here, to the auditorium. We could even recreate a Big Bang with the cognitive capabilities we evolved since millions of years. Only species which could evolve because it could adapt. So, why are we facing challenges to adapt? While Farida Faraz and her team said that during COVID, we adapted. Not all adapted. There were broken homes, divorced spouses, fights, quarrels, struggle, financial, otherwise, relationships. So while I'm focusing on the minuscule population who had challenges, that clan is growing. And if you isolate just COVID and look at the overall life we are leading, the conflicts we have in our life, whether they are professional, personal, relationship, workplace, or the kind of unconditional love we intend to give to our children, are being challenged because we have somewhere started questioning the need to adapt. We have become a little arrogant because we are much more secure physically, unlike our ancestors who kind of grew with a physical survival necessity of adaptability. Today we don't have a threat like that. So we teach sometimes, unfortunately, and unintentionally to children, be yourself. Maybe I'm crossing a line in talking about a cliched phrase. I'm not lecturing anyone. But when you say to a child, be yourself, at a very young age, I'm just picking one point, because I don't have time for much. Now, if an unformed, incomplete, evolving child is trained to be herself or himself, there is a level of adamance, there is a level of arrogance, there is a level of close-mindedness which develops over the period of time. And once they get into the teens and beyond, you see even individuals at 25, 30 in your workplaces or as partners or as professionals working for you, it's so hard to adapt to a new system. It's so hard to be professionals to disengage from their own value systems and sync with the organizational value system. That is why we have so many challenges in organizational culture. If you integrate businesses, if you acquire businesses, integration becomes such a hassle. In families, there is such a huge hassle of integration of a common parenting approach. Father says something, mother says something, and then the child can be confused. Because one bare minimum understanding of adaptability is you're never complete till you die. And when you die, you don't need to adapt to anything else. But till you die, you got to adapt at every single stage, right? From the boys who came here, the girls who came here, when they are, you know, the second to fifth grade, all the way till senior citizens who are living with their children, along with their children, or living by themselves, they need to adapt. So I share a small model with you before I wrap this in a couple of minutes. I call it OLA, you might even call it breaching a copyright of OLA. But the model I propose is open-mindedness, learning competence, and adaptability. Now, if we do not understand these three concepts in tandem, then we tend to be those individuals who will resist adaptability. And when you resist adaptability, I told you figuratively, but sometimes literally, we tend to die. So life is about adaptability, and death is the opposite of it. And even businesses or parents, if they are looking at open-mindedness, if you were to audit your home, how open-minded is your home? Do people listen to each other actually, or they are burying their heads in gadgets and TVs and the other avocations? Do people actually listen to each other? So the adaptability is about being open-minded to listen and observe so that you can change for better. Evolution is always change for better. And why should it stop at certain age? Why should it stop at a certain role? If I'm a principal, I can still adapt, I can still evolve, I can be open-minded, I can be observant of the opportunities and then move on. So open-mindedness is very critical to adaptability, and it applies to businesses, it applies to families, it applies to schools, it applies to teachers. No one is exception. Then comes the learning, the quest to learn, to be the better version of you. There are a lot of friends, I mean, as I said, I see some familiar faces here, not anymore in the darkness. But when we look back, I mean, all of you are young parents, but even if you were to look back and say, in my school times, I had these friends, and then you have a reunion and say, man, you are exactly the same like how you were 20 years back. And we are happy about it. Actually, you should be sad about it. You shouldn't be the same. I mean, you could grow so much intellectually, cognitively, emotionally. The economic part, I keep it aside. I mean, that's about individual competence, professional competence. But the rest of the story must have changed, should have changed. So we shouldn't be excited that we don't change. We should change and change for better. So the learning part, nobody needs to teach us this. I mean, we are all learners. But we have filters nowadays, thanks to the social media influencers, the unbelievable rage and unbelievable occupancy of pushing my ideas on somebody, pushing my beliefs on somebody, it is causing so much a damage to the young people. The learning is about independence to learn. And if children are not cut off from these influences, I'm not saying use force. I'm saying teach them how to be open-minded. Teach them how to be learning-oriented. Learning not just academics, learning cognitive capability, learning emotional capability. All our children are smart, but are they emotional? Do they give a hug back? Do they give a kiss back? Do they come and ask, Papa, give me a hug? Do they come to the mom and say, Mom, let me kiss you? Now, if they aren't doing that, man, they should be doing that. I'm not saying force them. I'm saying we got to look at the learning in multiple dimensions, not just in one. Education is not for just employment. Education is for empowerment, enablement. So the last is adapt. O-L-A. So if you don't adapt, then you run into conflicts. You don't adapt, you get into issues which you have to resolve today, tomorrow, day after. You lose control of your own, whether it's a business or it's your family or your individual social connections, if we don't adapt. So my dear friends, it's such a wonderful occasion. Such a nice evening where we all got together, and the short form of entertainment and showcase of the talent was absolutely fantastic. I was touched by the traditional way things were done in the top school of Telangana and also in India. And I think we should continue our traditional aspects and traditional journey. And I wish to congratulate all the teachers, the PSC members, and especially Principal Farida Fraz for leading such a beautiful show this evening. And thank you very much for having me this evening. Thank you.
Catherine Griesinger is a fan 50-star rock in G major scales with just a few opening strings in the violin. Their tune is surely going to mesmerize all of you. We now have our students performing this popular piece of instrumental music.
Thank you.
all. That was very soulful. This too shall pass. These magic words teach us the power of impermanence. The basic idea of these words is to remind us that whatever situation we are currently going through in life is temporary and will change. Legend has it that these words were engraved on a monarch's ring by his wise men to remind him that joy, sorrow, exaltation of victory, or desolation of defeat are temporary. Nothing is permanent in this world. We adapt. Everything changes except the law of change. We have experienced many elated moments and sorrows, support and setbacks, victories and defeats. They all have passed over a period of time, maybe short or long, but have eventually passed away, leaving us to face the oncoming task with more vigor and resolution. Through this play, we're iterating the idea that every difficult situation passes through only to bring good times with hope and aspirations.
The play includes dances through which the mood of the play is expressed. These dances include flash mob. Traditionally, dance flash mobs are when a group of people assemble in a public place to wow the crowd with an eye-catching dance routine. We have our young students here who are going to perform a refreshing flash mob for you all. Tarantella dance, named after a bull spider. This dance is a folk dance called Tarantella and is said to have originated from a region called Salento, located in southern Italy.
Fusion dance. Fusion dance is done within a community of social dancers that have a variety of views on what it means to fusion dance. COVID warrior dance. While India was struggling with the deadly second wave of COVID-19, it's not wrong to say that it was our healthcare workers disguised as corona warriors who made India survive the pandemic. Our grade 5 students here will be paying a tribute to all the healthcare workers. We hope you enjoy watching the play as much as we enjoy presenting it.
Oh, all wondering what is happening. I am wondering too, but I think I know what might happen. Let me take a guess. A play. Oh, the students and teachers thought we need to have more fun elements in the play. Yeah, sorry about that.
Yes, you should be.
Ayan and Sridhari.
Hello, wait a minute.
Why? We have a time limit to stick to. I think we are already behind schedule.
I know, but this story needs to be told the way it needs to be told. Aw, thank you.
Now can I start?
Fine.
Ayan and Sridhari return home from school after a long week. They are looking forward to going to the mall, do some shopping, play some arcade games and eat. Well, Ayan loves to hog.
Finally, it's the weekend. I get to play Minecraft all day.
Where's my phone? Where's my phone?
Where's Didi? Didi, I'm hungry.
Stop it, yeah, you're killing my vibe.
How was school?
Not now, Dadi.
Didi shows up. She is not your ordinary Didi. Didi got swag.
Again, let's make a reel like right now.
Array, thanks you. I already have 25,000 followers on TikTok.
What? Seriously, how many?
Array, I know that is not much, but try karein apan must.
Guys, stop. Didi, please make me some pakoras now. The school is killing me with healthy food.
Right away. Didi, can we make the reel in some time?
Sure.
Mom comes home. She enters and quickly plugs her phone onto charge and switches on the iPad. In a bit, Dad also enters. While talking on the phone, he opens his laptop and is constantly talking about investments.
Mama, let's go to the mall. You promised.
Sridhari, in some time. Don't you have your homework to do?
Please, right now. Please, can we go right now?
Fine, let's go. Get ready, both of you.
Beta.
Not now, Ma. Ayan, please get ready. Let's all go. It's been a while that we all stepped out.
No, I want to finish the game. Dude, you get to play the same in the arcade. Let's go.
Hey, can we go in some time? We don't have to cook. Fine, no food for you. Order something for yourself.
I'll miss your food.
They all get ready, including the grandmom, and they call for a cab.
Hello, kide janika?
You come first.
Madam, I am coming there only. Just to please tell.
Atrium Mall. Now don't cancel.
Acha. Okay. I also want to go there. On my way, madam.
That's the first time I got a cab so quick. The cab will be here in 5 minutes. Wait for me!
OTP, please.
It's 2019.
Just like this year. Where to?
Oh, by the way. This happened in 2019. Looks like one of us forgot to mention that.
Can we go now to the mall?
Seat belts, please.
They reach the mall. We see the entry to the mall. Outside, hawkers have set up shop.
Oh, why do these people crowd the entrance?
It's okay. Let's go inside. They have to work too.
Bhai, the scanner has gone pus-pus since 1 month.
Are kai ko tension? Just do bzzz, bzzz and let them enter, na?
Best idea, bhai.
Bzzz, bzzz.
Did you just make a noise? Next.
Right, they enter the mall. 2 levels of shopping. Lots of people around. I should have been a shopper instead.
What are you talking about? We got the best line.
Ahem, back to the story.
Slow down, kids.
They ignore her and keep running ahead. We see people making announcements. In the open space, we start hearing music. A flash mob happens. So much fun.
Yo soy Pablo Emilio Escobar Gaviria. Un día yo voy a ser presidente de la República de Colombia. Plata o plomo. Plata o plomo. Plata o plomo. Yo soy Pablo Emilio Escobar Gaviria. Plata, 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 plomo, plomo, plomo. Plata, 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 plomo, plomo, plomo. Plata, 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 plomo, plomo, plomo. Yo soy Pablo Emilio Escobar Gaviria.
few games. We see multiple shops with families, teens and young couples.
Ma'am, you should buy them. It suits you perfectly.
I think I like this one better.
Ma'am, you're so right. It suits you perfectly.
Actually, this one is only better.
You're so right, ma'am. Ma'am, that one is only better, ma'am.
Forget about H&M and Zara. Buy the latest jackfruit collection. Special discount for confused teen.
First of all, it's H&M, not Heminem. And yeah, whatever, who cares? And girl, that new Blackpink album, bro, it's so whack, man.
Nah, I think BTS will do a way better job. Oh, and by the way, did you check out that new merchandise store?
Ha yeah, I did.
Hello sir, please fill up this form. You could be a lucky winner.
No, thank you.
Sir, the first prize winner gets a car. A car, sir.
A car? Go to gym, ADS, BDS, yeah. Or 1, 2, 3. More details.
Please stay away from the railings, children.
To all the shoppers, welcome. Please avail your festive discounts today.
We bring the special offer only to our shoppers today.
Let your friends and family know.
During all this commotion, Dadi decides to go outside. She is talking to the hawkers and admiring their art. She talks to one such family, an older man and a few kids.
Thank you so much, Maji. Bitty has put a lot of effort.
Thank you so much, Beta. I hope you grow up to be a great artist.
Thank you, Maji.
The kids and mom finish shopping and head out.
What is the hurry? I think we should buy some of this.
Ma, we have enough of this at home. You don't know where they get it from.
Madam G, this is fresh. This is new. My dad and I just made this.
Beta.
Not now, Ma. Everyone, let's go.
They head home. That was a nice piece of art. Anyway.
Wait, did Dadi give that girl something?
Shh! The family go on about their regular lives and a few days pass.
Markets seem to be all over the place. Some virus is causing this.
Virus? Is that a new game? When is it out? How much is it?
It's already out, but trust me, you don't want it. Either to buy or for free. We might just have to pay a huge price not to have it.
Dad, what are you talking about? Pfft, you have no idea how simulation works.
They switch on the TV. We hear announcements being made.
How dare the virus speak over me? How dare? The nation wants to know. How dare you? How dare you?
Yes, it's true. COVID-19 has officially entered India. We urge the citizens to take all the necessary precautions needed to ensure complete safety. More information to follow once we have further details.
What's happening?
Please call the school and find out. Our office has already asked the staff to head home.
Okay. The school has decided to take a break. Should we be worried?
Let's not panic. We'll see what the government decides.
Beta?
Not now, Ma. This is super serious.
Didi is busy trying to look busy.
Yahoo! No school!
I know, right?
The government has declared 21 days of nationwide shutdown. Please buy all the necessary things needed.
Just as I thought, a lockdown. Kids, stay home and don't go out.
Oh no!
Kids?
Not now, Dadi.
We are having a lot of fun right now.
Let me call my friends. I'm going to game all day.
Let's not call anyone now. But I shall let you game, if you clean your room.
I have so much time to make the best reels. Oh, and Didi, can you help me?
Step into my office right away.
I can't game all day.
I'm so hungry. Even Didi hasn't come for a few days now.
Dadi!
Not now, Beta.
What? Did Dadi just not now us?
I know, right? What do you think she's up to?
Only one way to find out.
They go towards Dadi, who is sitting in the living area. We see that she is talking to someone through the main door at a distance. The kids go closer to get a better view. They see a girl in shabby clothes.
Ha, Dadi, thank you so much for helping us. It would have been tough otherwise.
What are you saying, Beta? I should thank you and many others.
Dadi, what are you doing? Get away from there right now!
I think you should apologize right now.
What are you saying, Dadi?
Beta, go now, come back tomorrow.
Okay, Dadi, I will leave now.
The girl leaves. The kids arguing with Dadi, saying she shouldn't have spoken to her.
You know you're old, and you're in the highest category of getting affected.
Also, Ma, did you think about the kids?
Guys, what is happening? I can't see.
Quiet, let me listen now.
Enough!
Not now, Beta. Let me speak. Do you have any idea how we managed to get supplies, even though there's a lockdown here? Do you know where our medicines and vitamins are coming from when we aren't allowed to travel to the city? No, you don't. It was a little girl and her family who has been helping us out. Not just us, the whole society. And the least I could do is give them food, money, and talk to them.
What? Isn't the maid taking care of that?
Actually, she hasn't been coming for the last few days. Her father passed away due to COVID.
Oh.
But I thought your driver was taking care of the supplies.
No, he has COVID. But he's lucky. His family is taking care of him. And he's out of danger.
Now you see, you all didn't let me buy anything from the shop the other day, outside the mall. It is the same family who has come forward to help us. The little girl's dad is an auto driver.
Oh, Daddy, we didn't know.
That is not all. Their mother passed away 6 days ago because no one came forward to help them.
Daddy, so sorry.
But Ma, why didn't you tell us?
Because this was the first time in years where I saw my family being a family and spent time together.
Ma, I don't know what to say. I really should have paid more attention.
Don't worry, Beta.
You're right, Ma. There are many people who have risked their lives to ensure we live safely. Be it doctors, electricians, delivery agents, and teachers too.
For a second, I got scared to see Dadi, but she is so right. We ought to thank many for their sacrifices. Oh, wait, the next program on TV is a dance dedicated to them.
The first case of COVID-19 was discovered.
The biggest quarantine.
One patient tested positive for coronavirus.
COVID-19 can be characterized as a pandemic.
First death being reported now from Karnataka.
We declared a public health emergency.
Gharon se bahar nikalne par puri tarah pabandi lagai ja rahi.
हाँ बेटा, बेटा रोज न्यूज में डॉक्टरों के बारे में देखकर अब डर लगता है. तुम ठीक तो हो ना?
हाँ माँ.
नन्ही सी हंसी भोली सी खुशी फूलों सी वो बाहें भूल गए. जब देश ने दी आवाज हमें हम घर की राहें भूल गए. चांद बुझे हमें नींद उसी दिन आएगी जब देखेंगे आबाद तुझे.
इस कोरोना के डर से लोग सिर्फ एक टच से घबराते हैं.
हम डॉक्टर्स हैं, रोज मौत से हाथ मिलाकर आते हैं.
तेरी मिट्टी में मिल जावा, गुल बन के मैं खिल जावा, इतनी सी है दिल की आरजू. तेरी नदियों में बह जावा, तेरे खेतों में लहरावा, इतनी सी है दिल की आरज़ू।
अस्पताल में लोग इस बीमारी से अकेले लड़ते वक्त
अपने परिवार का साथ चाहते हैं,
पर ऐसे हालातों में हम ही हैं उनके डॉक्टर, हम ही उनका परिवार, हम ही उनकी हिम्मत
और हम ही उनकी उम्मीद।
मजबूर हुई जब दिल की दुआ, तो हमने दवा से काम लिया, वो नब्ज नहीं फिर थमने दी, जिस नब्ज को हमने थाम लिया।
जवान अपनी जान की बाजी लगाकर सरहद की सीमा रेखा की रक्षा कर रहे,
लेकिन भारत की जीवन रेखा की जिम्मेदारी
अब हमारे हाथ है।
I feel so bad.
Okay, come here both of you. I have a story to tell you.
Dadi narrates a story to the kids. Ooh, this is gonna be fun.
As always, we forgot to tell the audience the title for our whole play.
This too shall pass.
King, and he once said to the court sages,
I have a ring with one of the finest diamonds in the world, and I want to inscript a message under it that can be useful in a situation of extreme despair. I will give this ring to my heirs, and I want it to serve faithfully. Think of what kind of message will serve this purpose. It must be very short to fit in the ring.
The sages thought and thought, but could not come up with anything.
Your Majesty, it is very tough to come up with a short phrase for someone as magnanimous as you.
I must agree with him, Your Majesty.
The king complained about the failure of his venture to a faithful old servant who raised him from infancy and was a part of the family. And the old man said to him,
I'm not a sage, I'm not educated, but I know such a message. For many years spent in the palace, I've met a lot of people. And once I've served a visiting mystic whom your father invited. And he gave me this message. Just don't read it, pass it to the craftsman, and only open it when there is no way out at all.
The king listened to the old and faithful servant. After some time, the enemies attacked the country and the king lost the war. He fled on his horse with the enemies in pursuit. He was alone and they were many.
I don't think he has gone too far. Search every corner!
He could not go back. The enemies were approaching, and he could already hear the clatter of their horses' hooves. He had no way out and was in complete despair.
We can't find him.
And then he remembered the ring, recognizing the time had come to look beneath the precious stone. He found an inscription.
This too shall pass.
After reading the message, he felt that everything was quiet. The pursuers got lost and proceeded in a different direction. Horses were no longer heard. The king was filled with gratitude to the servant and the unknown mystic. The words were powerful. He put the ring away. Again, he gathered his army and in due course returned to his palace and to power. The king arranged a magnificent feast for the whole kingdom. The people loved and celebrated their king. The king was happy and proud.
Thank you.
The old servant came up to him and in a soft tone urged him to
look at the message again.
Now I'm a winner. People are celebrating my return. I'm not in despair, not in a hopeless situation.
Listen to this old servant. The message works not only in moments when everything is bad, but also in moments of victory. And you are the one who told me about it.
The king looked at the ring and discovered, "This too shall pass."
Sire, everyone is waiting for you. We would be honored by your presence.
And again, he felt a silence fall over him. Although he was in the midst of a noisy dancing crowd, his pride dissolved. He understood the message. He was a wise man. And then the old man said,
"Do you remember everything that happened to you? Nothing and no feelings are permanent. As night changes into day, so moments of joy and despair replace each other. Accept them as the nature of things, as part of life."
That was a really touching story. Why are you feeling so sad?
I'm sorry, but both the kids are feeling sad as well.
We are sorry, Dadi. Really?
It's okay, beta.
Dadi, please tell us what we can do to help.
First, always listen to your mom and dad. They mean the best for you. Don't forget to wash your hands and remain clean.
I'm on it, Dadi.
And we will do our part to help the less needy. We are fortunate to have everything with us. Let us provide for the less fortunate.
Yay, Dadi! Best idea ever! Let's make a reel right now. I'll add Didi online.
We don't want to sound preachy and tell you what to do, but I hope we could entertain you. And also, maybe leave you with some words or acts of wisdom.
So see you later, alligator, give a hug, ladybug, hit the road, happy toad, out the door, dinosaur.
With dinosaur?
You get the message. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Where the ones they won't overlook. We'll take it all the way and live another day. Let's make a statement to the world.
message that is being conveyed. Let us rest assured that these days of trial and trouble, hardship, pain and grief caused by the pandemic throughout the world will not last forever. This too shall pass away. At the same time, let us try to live in the present and welcome each day, experience it, understand it, and face it with courage and intelligence to ultimately enjoy it. Because as Alice Marsall says, yesterday is history, tomorrow is a mystery, today is a gift. That is why it is called the present. Gautam Buddha also emphasizes the significance of living in the present by saying, the secret for both mind and body is not to mourn for the past, worry about the future, or anticipate troubles, but to live in the present moment wisely and earnestly.
The play included a few songs. These were Aashayan, which translates to hopes, is a beautiful song that speaks about striving hard and being hopeful to achieve all the yearnings of the heart. It surely motivates the listener to never lose hope, keep working towards the goals and achieve them. Hero by Pink Zebra is a heroic and motivational song that informs the listener to be like a hero, continuously dreaming and putting courage to the test. It motivates people to continuously take risks, explore and yearn for more.
Song in the Night. Song in the Night by Silver Wind is a beautiful number from the 80s. It is a song that would make anyone calm down during a rough night. It inspires children to be brave and face difficulties as they come.
Art is not what you see, but what you make others see. Edgar Degas. A young artist had an opportunity to reflect and express their observations, experience, and joy of being connected to nature. We have curated some of their artworks where they have expressed their perspective on how nature has inspired them and created the artwork based on their creative thinking. They have manipulated the art elements using critical thinking to communicate their artistic intentions on canvas. During this process of the experiential journey, they have acquired and demonstrated drawing, composition, and media application skills. We will now have on stage all the students who showcase their creativity through their artwork in the exhibition.
We now request Ms. Shweta Kotapalli, our Vice Principal, to propose the vote of thanks.
Chief Guest Mr. Krishna Sagar Rao, parents, teachers and our dear children. No one who achieves success does so without the help of others. The wise and confident acknowledge this help with gratitude. Alfred North Whitehead. I would like to start by expressing my sincere gratitude to our Chief Guest, Mr. Krishna Sagar Rao, for being here with us today, despite his busy schedule. It was indeed our privilege to have heard his thoughts, and I'm certain that it would have resonated with the students and the audience here this evening. To our young students who have been working consistently to put out this stellar performance this evening, you have made us extremely proud. You have showcased your dedication and ability to work in cohesion with your fellow students and staff members. Let's give a huge round of applause to these young eagles. I I'm certain these last weeks have been a learning curve for all of you. The repeated practice sessions and the amount of work and patience you have had to put into each of these sessions. Please remember that preparing for these events in itself is an enriching experience. An event like this by no means happens overnight. The teachers in PYP have consistently put in a great deal of effort and work to ensure that each of these students achieved his or her potential. A wholehearted thank you to all the teachers behind the scenes. A special thank you goes to our respected principal, Ms. Farida Fraz, who inspires us every day and is always a huge pillar of strength to all of us. I would like to thank our specialist team who are the architects behind the whole program. Mr. Pradeep, Ms. Sharmista Sarkar, and Ms. Shripadna Datta for the creative art exhibition that many of you would have viewed before coming to the amphitheater. Ms. Geeta Reddy and Ms. Vishnu Vandana for the lively dance performances. Mr. Arjun Anand for the beautiful play. Mr. Biju Mani, Mr. Sareen Rabaka, and Mr. Prasanna Kumar for the music. Ms. Sharayu Kolarkar for preparing the MCs, Ms. Sangeeta Muthialu for the invites, Ms. Sarita Chanda for coordinating the run-through, Ms. Namita for the costumes. Our PYP leadership team, Ms. Shweta Jolly and Ms. Sushmita Mohanty for continuously encouraging, guiding and preparing the students. To Ms. Pushpita Balakrishnan, our activities coordinator and the mastermind behind this whole event. Her planning and coordination ensured that the event was smooth and flawless. Her energy has been vital in making sure that the whole event was fun and lively. Thank you very much, Ms. Pushpita. Thank you, Mr. Mahesh, for all the financial support. Wing Commander Anand and his team for the relentless efforts in making this show a success. Thank you, leadership team, for your support. Our ICT team, Mr. Shravan and Mr. Prem, Prism for providing us with the refreshments, Mr. Amjad and team for their splendid work on stage. Thank you, our support staff, without whom none of this would have been possible. I would like to finally express my sincere gratitude to all the parents who made it out here today to witness the program. Thank you very much for being such a great audience. Thank you one and all. Have a good evening.
And the national anthem.